So I will try to start peppering my in my very good English with some French phrases here and there. Évidemment.
Putain.
He keeps calling me putain. What's that? I mean, it's some...
Wear it with pride.
Putin. He's calling me Putin with a French accent. I'm not stupid, you know. In today's episode, how do you do, Intermothers and Mother, welcome to Stories of My Life. So the sty is sort of better. I don't know what's going on. It's sort of... Last night was really sort of like, oh, what's going on? But now, nothing's going on. Well, something's going on. There's something going on. Agneta. Anyway, I'm on my way to the theatre to do some work. I need to organise things in the workroom. And after that, I'm not sure. Well, I'll definitely be doing something, so you just stay tuned. And if you have any questions about Oscarsteatern or anything you want to see there now that I'm there all alone, please ask me. Send me a DM, as they say. Or do they just say DM me? Slide into my DM. Okay, people, I'm going to show you something. That's the Gudrunkurien outlet. I live over there. This is an area, this is just before the bridge, that they sort of prospecting or building lots of new houses that are kind of ugly. But I never seen this before. This is, I think, they're building a really tall house here. But I don't know if this is the way they start assembling one of those cranes or if it's supposed to be like that. Stay tuned because I will update you in the build. Every time I go past here, I think, yeah, I will do that. So here's what they're doing. And I just want to show you these really ugly houses. I mean, they sort of look positively, I don't know, Russian? I don't know. When you think of something really bleak, this is what I conjure up. So here we go, people. Today, the weather, it's like it hasn't... it hasn't started. It could be 6 o'clock in the morning. It's sort of grey. And everyone seems a little bit stunned. So Douglas said that he wanted to see the auditorium and the balconies. So I'm going to go down on stage and show him and the rest of you as well. Yeah. Also, I texted Ulf and he said he wanted to go to Ikea. And I said, can you wait till I'm done at work? And I haven't got an answer yet. But, it might not be possible. I'm not sure if, I don't know how to turn the light up in the auditorium. Wait. Okay, people, so here we go. This is the iron curtain. This is a door. This is total darkness. Hello? No. As you can see here, it is fantastic. Although it's dark, you can still feel, well, nothing really. It looks like the sky. And as I said, I don't know how to turn on the lights. Wait, maybe. Okay, people, this said... Salon suisse, which means light in auditorium. Let's see what happened. Oh, yes. Oh, look. This theatre is over 100 years. I think it was built in 1911. They got these... Really nice. Oh, I might go out and show you how it looks like from the outside. From the in, well, sitting there. Now we are out in the foyer. Let's go in row B. Oh. So that's the iron curtain, and this is the way it looks. These sort of areas are called oxen heads in Swedish. I do not know why. No, oxen eyes. Oxöga. I do not know why. And I'm not sure who's supposed to be sitting in them or in any of them. You feel like that would be really nice to sit there, but it is not. You face outwards. So it's more for people to be seen than see. And this theatre is named after the king whose name was Oscar at the time. So this is the Oscar's theatre. Look at that ceiling. And also, let's see, if you want to change the light bulbs, you have to go up and sort of, it's really, really hard to change them because you can't walk on that part of the ceiling. So you have, there's long cords and you have to sort of pull them up, I think. Yeah. You're welcome. This was The More You Know with me, your tour guide, Torben Harkensen. And I mustn't forget to turn off the lights. Let's check. Oh yes, you can see there's no light seeping through under the iron curtain. No, back to work. Knock, knock. Oh, fuck. Oh. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Needle.
Needle who?
Need a little help right now.
Okay, I'm coming.
Okay, people, it's time to get going. I'm meeting Ulf in half an hour outside his building, and we're going to Ikea. He needs to buy a frying pan. I need to buy nothing. I looked at Ikea, what they have, and frightfully boring. Everything. It's like H&M right now. Everything's frightfully boring. Wait. Where is my glove? Okay, so I found my gloves. There are in the little pocket on my outside of my IKEA bag. I mean, they don't even have nice bags anymore at IKEA. A really jerky tutti mondi. Would you fucking believe it? It's raining. Damn it. Damn it to hell. So people, I was supposed to go to Ulf's place. Got soaked in the rain. Slowly soaked. It wasn't like one of those deluges, or it wasn't a deluge. I like that name. Word. But anyway, I just texted him, can you come to my place instead? And I didn't get an answer. And then I thought, oh, if he's fallen asleep in front of the telly, because he often does. So I called him and said, no, I'm awake. I'm just doing stuff instead of reading things on my phone. And then he said he'll be here to pick me up. He said he'd be here in half an hour, and I'm counting on an hour because, well, it's him. But doesn't matter. I'm home. I'm going to get dried out. No, I'm not an alcoholic, so I'm not going to get dried out. I'm going to get dry. We've just called. He's outside, so I'm going out into the wonderful Rhine. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, playing the disco music and dancing all night long. So people, here we go. IKEA. Ulf is wearing something fabulous. Do you want to tell my readers what you're wearing?
I'm wearing a very lovely duffel coat.
Yes?
From Uniqlo in cooperation with Jill Sanders.
Oh, Jill Sanders.
And it's a lovely, lovely...
Oh, I can feel it. Take a spin. Yes, walk. Strut. Fantastic. Oh, lovely. So remember those backpacks? I was happy because I got the last ones. Well, they've got rucksacks up their ass. So we're at IKEA and we saw this. This is new. Looking vintage. Oh, you can't close it? Oh, you can. Yeah, good. Just kick it. Wants to draw our attention to his funny socks. They're spotted. Fantastic. Oh, yes, funny. Yes, yes.
Klatschig,
as we say in Sweden. And by the way, if you want Sunbird Road's screens, you can still find them. I think, why don't they just mark it down? Because they've been here for half 6 months now. If they marked them down, I would buy them just to buy them. Just to have them on the balcony or something. People, this is a nice white table. They have it for years, but now they've got it in black and it's not really expensive. Ulf is going to buy one of these. And what are they good for?
To chop things up and put down in the bowl.
Yeah, because you place the bowl under here and you just... Whoosh. So, but you're not going to use it for that, are you?
Maybe. Or a thousand other things.
Oh, Ulf now demonstrates the way to do it, yes. All you need now is a knife and something to chop.
Put your hand there.
Okay. Beige, 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 beige. Ulf is looking for ways to spice up his apartment. It needs colour, he says. It needs print. So he bought one of those Sandra Rhodes. Oh, you should. Totally atrocious.
It's like a hooker's underwear.
Well, you would know.
Yeah.
So here's a new sort of blanket. He's lost that loving feeling. Oh, that loving feeling. He's lost that loving feeling. Now he's gone, gone, gone. Also, we saw this carpet here. Oh, really nice, really big, really not very expensive. Having fun? He's thinking about buying this, and I say, go for it. Your apartment is a travesty in bad taste. You need something to spice it up, spruce it up, spice it up. No, this is lovely.
New friends, maybe.
How very rude. In our surprise, we think it's the first time we ever see it. Look at this depressed man. Why? Because they're sold out. There aren't any more. Can I have a reaction shot, maybe with tears? Snot. Yes, give me some snot.
No.
No. Just tears?
No.
No tears?
No.
You look depressed. This is a man who keeps going on. He doesn't give up. No. Now he's thinking about buying two of these instead, which would cost him more than one of those. But it might be magnificent.
Quite as big.
Yes. And reverse.
Did you go to the pizza? You didn't go anywhere.
It's like the Death Star. Oh. Well, some weird hat. This is a lamp, but the thing is, Mr. Holt is a place, but Mr. Holt, where we drive by when we're going to visit my parents. It's a place called Mr. Holt, and also a person, we think. And now a lamp. Ulf is thinking about buying a frame. Because one of your pictures just fell down and broke, right? So, but he's not quite sure about that white ledge, or whatever you call that, on that side. I think it's tremendously interesting. But then I don't have the taste he has. People, I just found this frozen meal, which is plant mashed potatoes, broccoli and sauce and plant balls, vegan. Fantastic. It's a breakthrough. It's a breakdown. It's a breakup. It's a break. Oh, Ulf is getting irritated with some screaming kid. It's not me, is it? Okay, good. Okay, people, they got vegan soft serve ice. I need to get one. We were so happy that we're in your queue and we're standing there waiting for someone to sort of make eye contact, and then we realize this is how you order. You don't talk to people no more. So here we go. Oh. That's me now waiting for my order.
The store is now closed.
Oh. I'm gonna get it. I'm gonna get it.
We will keep the
cashier's making it. Say something enchanting about. So we are getting the bums rush in melody, dear. Here we go. Vegan ice cream, first time ever. Mm. That man. Was quite good looking. We've seen him all over. Everywhere we were, he was. He's keep following us. It's almost harassment if it wasn't so nice. I mean, harassment can't be nice, can it? Well, it's a nice harassment. Mm. This is almost like a sorbet. Quite good. Parked one story up, and we are quite within Corona distancing. We are the only car here. And soon there will be none because it will be leaving without me. So Ulf parked the car, and this time without any incidents, like ruining his, whatever that is, rear view mirror or whatever. Seems to be a flood. We are buying vegan kebab and then going home to Ulf to see that fascinating show. What's the name of the fascinating show?
I don't remember.
It's a great name.
Yeah.
I don't remember. No, actually, the name is... Don't call... Please call my agent.
Yeah.
It's about a secret agent, I think. So we are going in here. They have great food. So I made the guy behind the counter order for me because I didn't know what to choose, and he'll choose this for me. Ulf is eating Pips January, an Asian-inspired pitta bread. Pitta. I just found this beer called Snubble Juice, which means stumble juice. And we think, because that's not a Swedish beer, we think it might be Danish or Norwegian. This is great. I'm getting kebab, salad, tomatoes, and fried potatoes. What do you call it? Fried potatoes? Yeah. Pickled onion. Oh, I'm hungry. Here we go, people. Hungry as can be. Oh. So, people, here we are again. The telly is not yet on. It's not on. Siri, put the television. Oh, now it's on. This is so good, people. Now it's time for something French. We've seen two episodes of Calling My Agent or Call My Agent. It's really good. Netflix, Call My Agent. C'est français, c'est très bien. Ulf is now going to take me home. Take me home to my home. Take me home.
Never.
So having seen that French TV series, I say lots of things in French now. I said, le voilà. That's French. I just said it. Entrée. Non, sortie. De l'escalier.
Ta gueule.
Oh, my goodness. L'escalier est...
Et là-bas.
Et là-bas. Ah. C'est le ceci est une friolite. Quoi?
Un ascenseur.
Ascenseur. Oui, nous sommes en un ascenseur. On parle français couramment, n'est-ce pas?
Oui.
So I will try to start peppering my in my very good English with some French phrases here and there. Évidemment.
Putain.
He keeps calling me putain. What's that? I mean, it's some...
Where is with pride?
Putin. He's calling me Putin with a French accent. I'm not stupid, you know. No, I haven't got that many mirrors because I like to look at myself, but I like to sort of... I like the brightness and the airiness it gives to a room. Like that, it seems like you can look into it and there's another room. Dead wet. This, could you see? This is all wet. This dirty old bag.
Santa Claus.
I'm going to flex. Thank you for watching and for liking, commenting, subscribing and following. It really helps, and something to do with the internet and the algorithm, I think. So thank you so much.